Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. My name is Carol, and the name of my channel is My Blessed Nest. Today, I'm participating with Kenya's Decor Corner in her fall lantern collab. Kenya loves lanterns, and so do I. So I am always so happy to participate in her seasonal lantern collabs. Would you like to see what I came up with? Then let's get started.
The lantern that I chose to use in the collab was purchased recently at a garage sale for just 50 cents. The sides had plastic with deer on them on each side, and it was cracked. So that's not really the look I was going for, not my style. So I just took my trusty knife and sliced along the edges and got as much of that plastic out of there that I could. Don't forget, this video is part of a collab. So that means go to my description box and look for the host channel. That's Kenya's Decor Corner. If you're not familiar with her channel, I invite you to go and check out her channel. And if you like it, subscribe. Also, don't forget to check out the playlist. A whole lot of my friends will be making videos and putting them up for your enjoyment. So if you go over to their channel for mine, please be sure to let them know I sent you. After I got all that plastic removed, I wanted to mix up a copper paint. So I Googled how to make your own copper paint. And basically, you need a burnt umber, a yellow, and a red. So here I'm showing the colors I picked. I actually used all apple barrel colors. I used a burnt umber, the color yellow, and the color apple Indian red. That's an old paint that I've had for a long time. So if that's not available, just find another red that you like. Here I'm starting out with a large amount of burnt umber, and then I'm adding in small amounts of the red and yellow. And as you can see, I have a piece of paper underneath where I'm mixing my paints. And every once in a while, I just test it to see how it looks until I get the desired color. I want to encourage you to just experiment with paint. If you feel a little bit leery of mixing your own colors, don't be. It's a lot of fun. And really, if you don't get the desired color that you wanted, the worst that can happen is you have to start over. But it's a lot of fun, and as you can see here, my paint just looks like a chocolate brown. But don't worry, I do end up getting it to look coppery in the end, so stick with me. Here I am painting all the little nooks and crannies underneath, and the sides, and the bottom. Now, you'll notice I always like to leave something to hold on to till the very end so that I can maneuver my item around. So I didn't paint the ring on the top until the very end. So that's just a little tip for you there. If you're enjoying my video and you like my content, why not subscribe to my channel? It's free and it sure helps my channel a lot. So if you do subscribe and you want to make sure that you don't miss out on any of my videos, make sure you hit the button that says all. And that way you'll be notified every time I post a new video. If you're interested in watching the other lantern collabs that I have participated in with Kenya, I'll be sure to link them below in the description box. At this point, I decided I need a little bit of help with my coppery effect. So I'm going to use this Deco Art Metallic Paint in the Champagne Gold. It took a little bit of playing around to get the effect I wanted, but I started out by outlining some of the lines of the lantern with it, and I just kind of dry brushed it on. I highlighted some of the raised area at the top and then along the edges, and it took a while to get the effect I wanted, but I just played around with it, and at one point I think I added on some more of my copper mix with the brown, the burnt umber, and just kept going back and forth and tweaking it until I got the look I desired. So if you're painting and it's not looking exactly like you like it, don't panic. You haven't ruined your project. Just keep dabbing on a little bit of this and a little bit of that until you get the effect that you want. Here you can see that all of the details are being highlighted by this metallic paint and they're starting to pop. And that's the fun part. Once I was finished with highlighting with the metallic paint, I went back in to tone it down with some of the burnt umber mixture. The last step that I did was I took an old stencil brush and I kind of pounced on to the lantern with the burnt umber mixture, and I even mixed some of the metallic paint in here and there, and that gave it a hammered look and kind of blended everything together so that the metallic wasn't too bright and it wasn't too dull with just the burnt umber. So I forgot to film the part with the stencil brush, but you do see me pouncing on it with my regular brush here, and that's when I realized a stencil brush would be even better. So once I was happy with the look, I left it dry good, and then for the most fun part of all, I was ready to put it into my little tablescape and show you how I'm going to use it to decorate for fall. So would you like to see how I did that? Let's take a look. I have my little fall vignette on my dining room table, and I have it in a tray that I made for another collab. I'll link that in the description box if you missed it. I decided to light my little orange votive candle to give it a nice candlelight glow. I have a couple pumpkins that I got on clearance last season. And then this little gold clock I thought was perfect coloring for the look that I wanted for fall. I got it at an antique store. There's my old standby scarecrow that I've had for years. A secret sister gave it to me, and she really nailed my style. You know I love pickup trucks, so that's my plate I picked up last year at Hobby Lobby. And then recently I garage sailed and found a ton of artificial flowers and leaves, so I made this little arrangement in an old Yankee candle jar, and I put some filler in to give it some interest and to help hold the flowers up. I just scattered some fake leaves into the bottom of the tray. And there you have it! There's my lantern collab. Let's take a look with the lights off. Look at that beautiful candlelight glow. There's a better look at my tray. Okay, let's turn the lights back on and take a look at my thrifted tablecloth. I just adore the scarecrows that are on it.
I hope you enjoyed seeing the transformation of my little garage sale lantern. If you did, let me know in the comments below. What's coming up next? Wednesday, September 2nd, I'll be live at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, answering your questions about organization. If you have a question, make sure to let me know. You can put it in the comments below of this video, or you can find my post on Instagram about the live or on my community tab. I'm looking forward to answering all your organization questions. If you'd like to follow me on Instagram, I'll link it below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye!